The Jotuns must learn to fear me, just as they once feared you.
That's pride and vanity talking, not leadership. You've forgotten everything I taught you. But a warrior's patience.
While you wait and be patient, the Nine Realms laugh at us. The old ways are done. You'd stand giving speeches while Asgard falls.
You are a vain, greedy, cruel boy!
And you are an old man and a fool!
Yes. I was a fool. To think you were ready.
Father.
Hey!
Thor. Odin's son, you have betrayed the express command of your king. Through your arrogance and stupidity, you have opened these peaceful realms and innocent lives to the horror and desolation of war! You are unworthy of these realms, unworthy of your title! You're unworthy! The loved ones you have betrayed. I now take from you your power, the name of my father, and his father before, my Odinor father, cast you out!
Whoever holds this hammer, if he be worthy, shall possess the power of Thor.
All right, Shalom. This is your brother Nahalia from the GMS Orlando camp. I want to start off by giving all praise, honor, and glory to Yahweh, Bahashem, Yahweh Shai, Bahashem, Rokah Kodash. Double honors to the apostles and the elders of Great Millstone, who are the elders of Yasha Allah. And a sincere salutation to all you Akim, who are preaching this word and believing this word, and to the Akwath, who are believing this word, and all truth and in sincerity. Yahweh is the name of the one they ignorantly call God. Yahweh Shai is the name of the one they ignorantly call Jesus. Bahashim is in the name. Rakah is spirit. Kodash is holy. Akyam is brothers. Akwath is sisters. Shalom means peace. And Yashar Allah is Israel in the ancient Paleo Hebrew. All right. And we have just, got through another Passover through the spirit. You know, Lord willing, it's the last Passover. You know, but as I'm driving through the spirit and meditating, the Lord has humbled us as we were once proud princes, you know. Right now, Esau is considered the proud prince, but at one point, it was us as a nation of people. And the reason my thought process went to this through the Spirit is that, you know, we're grateful just to be able to celebrate the Passover, just to make it to another Passover. Lord willing, it be the last one in Babylon. But you think about the ancient world. We had our own temple. We had a process, we had a ceremony amongst us as a nation of people. We weren't scattered like we are today. You know, we were able to come back to Jerusalem and celebrate the Passover as a nation of people. Now we're a small sanctuary everywhere we've been scattered. Real quick. This is Ezekiel chapter 11, verse 16. Therefore say, thus saith the Lord, Yahweh Bashem Awashai, although I have cast them far off among the heathen, and although I have scattered them among the countries, yet will I be to them as a little sanctuary in the countries where they shall come. Because again, we were proud princes at once. You have our people who play victim concerning the curses befalling us in the condition that we're in. But it's because we were proud princes. As the scriptures say, Jeshurun waxed fat and kicked. And now we're in a position through the spirit, Lord willing, we be a part of that number, where we're grateful for anything the Lord gives us, man. And that's because we have been humble. You know, the Lord cast us down as proud princes, and now we're being humbled so that, Lord willing, we can return to our rightful estate in righteousness, man, in humility. You think about the King of Kings, HaMashiach. If anybody had the reason to brag or boast, it would be him. Yet, as the scriptures say, he is lowly, meek, and lowly in heart, man. And we're learning that through the discipline that the Lord has given us. All right. That's why this is a perfect judgment for us. You know, brothers were talking about this over the highways and hedges. And yesterday, too. That the perfect punishment for princes is to make them servants. You know, and on another level, the perfect punishment for immortals is to make them mortal. And what does that create? It creates humility. It creates humbleness. Because we fail, but the Lord is going to give us that hope back. He's going to give us that position back through the Spirit. And that's where our hope lives. All right. But this punishment is beautiful because it creates humility in us, man. Real quick, this is Lamentations chapter 5. And I want to jump down to verse 7. And it reads, our fathers have sinned and are not, and we have borne their iniquities. And why is that? Because we are our forefathers. That's why the curses befell us. The Lord didn't curse a nation of people who were just newly on the earth. We've been here before. And that's why the curses follow us every time we're born into the earth. All right, continue with verse 8. Here's the point. Servants have ruled over us. There is none that doth deliver us out of their hand. And that's the perfect punishment, because at one point in time, we were in the land of Israel. All right. And we understood that the other nations were our servants. We understood that the Lord would deliver us. We understood that the Lord delivered us from Egypt. And that created a proud attitude in the nation of Israel, which is why we went into captivity. You know, you think about that. Growing up in the land of Israel with the temple right there, the priesthood right there, hearing about all the wonderful things the Lord has done for us whenever we prayed and came back to the Lord. So our people did what? They used the Lord like a get out of jail free card, just like 2/3 of our people to this day. They only call on the Lord when they need him, while doing nothing that the Lord asked them to do. Well, this is a very beautiful lesson in humility that the Lord has given us, man. And that's why the scriptures say this. Ecclesiastes chapter 17, and I'm going to jump down to verse 17, all right? And it reads, for in the division of the nations of the whole earth, he set a ruler over every people, but Israel is the Lord's portion, whom, being his firstborn, he nourisheth with discipline, and giving him the light of his love, doth not forsake him. The world believes we're forsaken, but really this was the Lord having a disciplining us for a moment to teach us a valuable lesson in humility and rulership and mercy, so that once we are returned to our rightful estate, we'll remember these lessons through the Spirit as we are given judgment over the heathens. And it's a beautiful lesson when you look at it through the Spirit. Think of how grateful you are for every little thing the Lord does for you, man. Brothers were talking about this yesterday. You find your keys after losing them, and you say, Tawadi Haobashim El Shah. Man, you go through a light and it's yellow, and you don't know if you're gonna make it past by the time it hit red, and then you make it and you say what? Tawadi Haobashim El Shah. It makes us grateful for every little thing. You know, as princes, we're now servants to other nations. And as bitter as that is, it creates humility. Because now we're appreciative of everything through the Spirit. Whereas in the ancient world, we weren't necessarily as grateful because we had it all. We were spoiled kids in righteousness, and the Lord had to give us a very beautiful lesson in discipline. So now we have to serve our servants. Now we have to go to our enemies for the one of all things. But through that, look at the attitude that the elect, Lord willing, we be a part of that number, have toward Yahweh Bashim Shah, man. We appreciate every little thing the Lord does for us because we know that he don't have to do it, man. At one point, we lost that mindset of understanding the Lord don't have to do shit for us, man. He don't have to do shit for us, man. And he did it. And he taught us this lesson. That's why whom he loved, he chasteneth. And we're learning a beautiful lesson in righteousness through the Spirit. Even though it's bitter, you know, even though at times it's hard. I mean, it's hard all the time, but there are harder times than others. Yet, look at the fruit that it's producing. You know, there's an old Latin saying, I forget exactly how it's pronounced, but it says the result justifies the means. Basically meaning, you know, however the process goes, the results speak for themselves. And if you look at the result, it justifies whatever's been done. And the Lord nourished us with discipline, man. And through that discipline, we're learning All right, how to not be proud, princes. All right, real quick, because we use this against Esau. This is Ecclesiastes chapter 10. And I'm going to jump down to verse 14. The Lord hath cast down the thrones of proud princes and set up the meek in their stead. Now, we know that Esau right now is the proud prince. But at one point in time, it was us. You know, think about how prideful Jake had become at a point in ancient Israel. You had the law, statutes, and commandments. You know, you had the temple with the incense burning. You know, you think about we had a government. We had princes. We had elders at the gates. We had our own land. We knew that the heathens were under us. Think about that kind of environment. When you think about how proud our people are now in captivity, just imagine us being in our own land, man. And that's why it was a great mercy that the Lord did this to us. All right. Matter of fact, it touches that in 2 Maccabees, the 2 Maccabees chapter 6 and verse 12. Now, I beseech those that read this book that they be not discouraged for these calamities, but that they judge those punishments not to be for destruction, but for a chastening of our nation. Because at one point we took it for granted, man. You know, it makes you think about that a lot. We took these things for granted. That the Lord chose us as a nation of people. That the Lord gave us our own land. That the Lord did great things for us. At one point, as a nation of people, we took that for granted. And that's why it was taken away from us. And it was a chastening. And it shows the Lord loves us because he didn't allow us to continue in that way unto perdition, unto destruction. But he chastened us so that, matter of fact, let's go into verse 13. For it is a token of his great goodness when wicked doers are not suffered any long time, but forthwith punished. For not as with other nations, whom the Lord patiently forbeareth to punish, till they become to the fullness of their sins, so dealeth he with us, lest that, being come to the height of sin, afterwards he should take vengeance of us. So the Lord, instead of being able to take vengeance on us, he chastened us quickly. That's why we've always been in these captivities. And that's why in 2 Maccabees, the 6th chapter, is telling you, don't get discouraged when you read these things. It's a sign of the Lord's mercy that he continued to put us in captivity instead of taking vengeance upon us. As it reads in Wisdom of Solomon, the 12th chapter, whereas he chastens us, he scourges our enemies 1,000 times more, man. And this is a beautiful lesson in humility. Our Lord, our King, man, had to submit himself unto death. He had to be subject unto death. Though he was Lord of all under Yahweh. And he's the prime example. He's the biggest example we have of humility as a nation of people, man. And that's why the Wadi Hal Bashim Al Shafa, this lesson. You know, the Wadi Hal Bashim Al Shafa, for bringing us into captivity, for bringing this all full circle so that we appreciate everything that the Lord does for us, knowing that he don't have to do it, man. Even now, Lord willing, we be a part of that number. Our salvation, it's all upon the Lord's mercy. It's not upon works. Because at one point with the law, Jake became proud. The laws that they could actually keep, they became proud. And they looked at each other like, I'm more righteous than this man. When you deal with this wicked scribes, the wicked Pharisees, that was their attitude. That was their sentiment. They were proud and they were using the law to be proudful against each other. And the Lord had to break us down to the lowest common denominator and then build us back up. And that's why it's beautiful. Matter of fact, that remind me of 2 Esdras chapter 9. All right. 2 Esdras chapter 9, and I'm going to jump down to verse 20. So I considered the world, and behold, there was peril because of the devices that were come into it. And I saw and spared it greatly, and kept me a grape of the cluster and a plant of a great people. Let the multitude perish then, which was born in vain, and let my grape be kept and my plant. For with great labor have I made it perfect. All of these trials and tribulations, whether it's personal or whether it's us as a nation of people, is to perfect the nation of Israel, beginning with the elect. Because 2/3 will be perfected after they learn this through death by pain. And then they will be the children of the elect. And so all Israel will be saved. And this whole lesson that we've learned in and out of these captivities will finally be realized, man. All right, so I just wanted to touch on that through the Spirit. Lord willing, this was edifying with that. I want to give all praise, honor, and glory to Yahweh, Bahashem, Yahweh Shai, Bahashem, Rakakodash. Double honors to the apostles and the elders of Great Millstone, who are the elders of Yasha Allah, and a sincere salutation to all you Akim, who are preaching this word and believing this word, and to the Akwath, who are believing this word, in all truth and in sincerity. Shalom.